25. To ascertain what is Atma Swarupa, first Atmanatma Viveka is being given. The discrimination between Atma, the true I, and Anatma, whatever that is not I, not only not I, but mistaken as I. It is not I, but mistaken as I. So that is, that distinction is being given. In this context, the gross body was described. In the context of the gross body, the Vishayas form a trap. That also means, that is the Vishayas, how they bind, that also was described. Now, the Sukshma Sharira, subtle body comprising of 5 Jnanendriyas, 5 Karmendriyas, Mana, Buddhi, Ahankara, Chitta, Antakarna, and 5 Pranas. Prana is one. Prana corresponds to the physiological functions in our body. It is one Vayu Vikara, but because of the function and the modification, it appears as 5 in number. We are familiar with this name, Prana, Apana, Vyana, Udana, Samana. You know, Brahmins, before eating, they say, what do you know? Pranayasva, Apanayasva, Vyanayasva, Udanayasva. And somebody said afterward, Jehu Basva. Eat now, eat now. So therefore, that is Pranayasva. Actually, you are supposed to give that much and get up also. Anyway, this prana, the 5 vital airs, the 5 physiological functions, they are now being described because they constitute the one of the aspect of the Sukshma Sharira. And we know this Sukshma Sharira, we'll come to that after. See, generally a person dies, now pran chale gaya bolte hai na, pran chale gaya, which pran chale gaya? Actually, this is a part of that Sukshma Sharira. What goes is Sukshma Sharira, also called as the Linga Sharira. And it constitutes the prana as one of the constituent as such. We say as what? Pran chale gaya. Pran chale gaya. You say, wo chale gaya bolte hai, pran chale gaya. So and so chale gaya. So and so chale gaya. Why? So and so's body is still lying there. How can you say so and so gaya? The jiva prana, that is what that. Now these 5 pranas, they are now being described. He says, actually they are modifications of vayu, and prana is one. But he says, vikruti bhedat, because of the vikara, different types of modifications that one prana undergoes. So what is that modification? How an illustration is given? What is that? Suvarna saliladivat. Suvarna is gold. Gold is one metal, but many ornaments are made. Bangles, earring, necklace, like that many ornaments are made. What has happened now? Vikara bheda. And say metal is one, gold is one, but many ornaments are there, like that. Again, saliladivat. Water. Water is one, but you find wave, then again bubbles, foam, spray particles on the ocean. You will go that where the wave comes and lashes, spray particles of the water emerge. So, but this is different names or not, but stuff is what? Only one and the same water. Like that, main prana is one, but because of the different modification that undergoes, how? Vritti-bheda. Vritti-bheda means due to distinction in the function. Vritti is function. So therefore, vikriti-bheda suvarna-salilavat asau prana. This prana, this vital air, vritti-bheda. Vritti means here function on account of different types of functions. Vritti-bheda. Svayameva, on its own, nobody does something as such, on its own, svayameva, what does it do? Prana, apana, vyana, udana, samanaha bhavati. Prana is one, now it has become what? Five pranas, five sub-pranas. What are those? The one is prana, say mukhya prana. And sub prana is the one of them is also prana. So prana, apana, vyana, udana, samana. So that were total five. Let us see what is prana, what is apana, etc. What is prana is pragamanavan vayuhu. Prana is pragamanavan vayu. Pragamanavan means what? Urdhva gamana shilaha vayuhu. The vayu which has got an upward trend. Which has got an upward trend. So that is what is called as means which corresponds to our respiration. Our respiration. And where is it? What is the sthana for that? Nasagra sthana varti. The sthana. The place is nasagra, the tip of the nose. That vayu which has got upward trend and its place is the tip of the nose corresponding to respiration. So that is what is called as the prana. Which prana? Not mukhya prana. One of the five divisions. Prana. Then apanaha nama. Second one is apana nama, adhogamanavan vayuhu. Adhogamanavan means, that is adhogamana shilaha, the one which has got downward trend. Prana has the upward trend, this has got the downward trend. Where it abide? Payu adi sthanavarti. It abides in the payu and upastha. Payu is anus, upastha is genital. Its function is evacuation. Malamutra visarjana. That which throws out the feces and the urine from the body. That is the job of who? Apana vayu. Now vyana. Vyano nama Vishwagamanavan. Vishwagamanavan. He goes everywhere. Goes everywhere means what? He goes in and through all the nadis, in and through your all arteries, veins and capillaries and all that corresponds to the circulation. So, what is the vyana? Vishwagamanavan vayuhu. Vishwagamana means sarvanadi gamanashilaha. Where is it? Akhila shariravarti. In the entire body, this who vyana abides. Udano nama. So what is called as udana is, and what sthana is, kanthasthaniyaha. It's a region stays where it stays, throat. And what is this? It is ऊर्ध्वगमनवान उत्क्रमण वायु. ऊर्ध्वगमनवान मीन्स नॉट द प्राण, उत्क्रमणशील मीन्स द वन हू इजेक्ट्स. One who ejects. You know what is the function of this? To some extent vomiting, etc. But this vayu fully functions only once in lifetime. You know when? At the time of death. This is the vayu which throws off like a rocket, no? The sukshma sharira from the sthula sharira. This vayu is the one when fully functioning at when? At the time of death, it just ejects the sukshma sharira out from the sthula sharira. And that is what we call as death. Death is separation of sukshma sharira from the sthula sharira. So long as sukshma sharira, subtle body, or also called as linga sharira, is going to come now, it's still not defined. He is going constituent, and afterwards, what is subtle body is going to be defined as a. It so long as that is there in the embodiment, what happens? Embodiment is lively and kicking. Movement sukshma sharira departs. It's a dead mass. You know why? In the sukshma sharira, one constituent is antakkarana. In antakkarana, chaitanya, the pure awareness principle, the atma swarupa, gets reflected, and that reflected chaitanya, called chidabhasa, that enlivens the body. We will be seeing now, we need not hunt for atma. We have got clear cut proof. How is that? Are you alive? Are you able to listen to me? Whether you understand or not doesn't matter. So, is it that? See, that is that. How are you able to do that? That is because of chidabhasa available to this body through the medium of antakkarana, that is sukshma sharira. That's why that sukshma sharira will be called as linga sharira. Otherwise, how can you know Atma? Here is a clear-cut evidence that Sachetana Tattva, the Atma, is there. Why? Our body is Sachetana. You see, it is going to come. You see. So therefore, this is Udana is Kanthasthaniya, and it is Urdhvagamanavan means Utkramana Shilavan. So the one who ejects the subtle body, to some extent, omitting also is possible because of that. Samano nama, samana vayu, sharira madhyagataha. It is in the middle of the body. Do you know where is the middle of the body? Stomach. It is in the stomach, jathara, jathara. What does it do? Its job is samikarana karaha. Samikarana kara means actually it digests ashita anna pitaadi, ashita pitaannaadi, not ashita anna pitaadi, ashita pitaannaadi, ashita anna pita jala, or whatever that is a liquid. Whatever that we eat and drink, that is what it is done. It is what? Samikarana. You know, samikarana means making the same. You know, I hope you know what happens in digestion. Whatever you eat, afterwards gets what? It gets churned. It gets churned. And it becomes the rasa. It becomes the rasa. That rasikarana, that making the rasa, is job of who? Samana. It is the function of the samana. So therefore, samikarnaha, so that is what samana vayu, where it abides, sharira madhyagataha, madhyagataha, abides in the body. So therefore, prana is one, but on account of its vikara in terms of five modification. It is called prana, apana, vyana, udana, samana. Is it not? Do this function take place in our body or not? Prana is viridhi there. Having described the constituents of sukshara, so now what is sukshara is defined and its modifications will be described.
Vagadi pancha, shravanadi pancha. Pranadi pancha, brahmukhani pancha. Buddhyatya vidya picha kama karmani. Uryashtakam sukshma shariram ahuhu. Vagadi pancha, shravanadi pancha.
Vagadi pancha, shravanadi pancha.
Pranadi pancha, brahmukhani pancha.
Pranadi pancha, brahmukhani pancha.
Buddhyadya vidya picha kama karmani.
Buddhyadya vidya picha kama karmani.
Uryashtakam sukshma shariram ahuhu. वागादि पंच श्रवणादि पंच प्राणादि पंच अभ्रमुखानि पंच बुद्ध्याद्य विद्यापि काम कर्मणि च उर्यष्टकम् सूक्ष्म शरीरम आहु. अगेन वागादि पंच श्रवणादि पंच प्राणादि पंच अभ्रमुखानि पंच बुद्ध्याद्य विद्यापि काम कर्मणि च पुर्यष्टकम् सूक्ष्म शरीरम आहु.
This is what is called as sukshma sharira. What all those? Vagadi pancha. Vak is organ of speech. What does it refer to? Organs of action, karmendriya. The five karmendriyas, I hope you know. What are those? What are those? Speech, vak, pani, paya, payu, pada, upastha. Speech, hands, legs, then this anus and genital. So these are now you have to take these five as one unit, because puryashtaka is there, a city comprising five things, eight things as puryashtaka. So now, Vagadi Pancha, Shravanadi Pancha, the five Jnanendriyas. Shravana means here, sense of hearing, ear. Eyes, ears, nose, tongue, touch. So these are the five Jnanendriyas. Vagadi stands for five Karmendriyas, Shravanada stands for five Jnanendriyas. Two units. Pranadi Pancha. The five vital as prana, apana, vyana, udana, samana. Third unit. Abhra mukhani pancha. Abhra means space, akasha. Beginning with akasha means the five elements. Again, here you have to take the sukshma five elements. Apanchikrita pancha mahabhuta. Not the panchikrita, not the gross five elements, but the subtle five elements. So that is what is abhramukhadi. How many? Four totally. Vagadi one, shravanadi two, pranadi three, panchabhramukhadi 4. Buddhi, buddhyadi. Buddhyadi, come on, tell me what it stands for. Antakarana. Buddhi, ahankara, buddhi, mana, and chittam. Faculty of recollection, chittam. So that is buddhyadi. Buddhyadi, that is antakarana. Avidya api. Again, avidya. So avidya. So the buddhyadi is 5th. 6th is avidya. Avidya is ignorance of oneself. Ignorance of oneself. Again. So avidyadi. Avidya and its modification. Its modification. So that will say further. Adi for adhyasa. In adhyasa, mistaking anatma to be atma. Say, what a vasanas or samskaras in the sukshariva. Kama karmani. Kama, ichha, desire. Karmani, that is karma karmani, two karmas, that is papa and punya, dharma and adharma. Dharma stands for punya, adharma stands for papa. So therefore, totally how many now? 8. 4 in first line, buddhyadi antakarana 5, avidya 6, kama 7, karma 6. It says karmani, it says cha, puryashtakam. A puri of 8 constituents. Or you can take 8 puris. Which puri? Not Bhelpuri. Puri means city. Jagannath Puri. Jagannath Puri. Because nowadays Pura, Puri are not as a Mumbai Puri. Bombay Puri. That is a city. So therefore, Puryashtakam. Sukshma Shariram. It is called Sukshma Sharira. Earlier was called was Sthula Sharira. Why it was called Sthula Sharira? Made up of Sthula Panchamahabhutas. Whereas this is made up of Sukshma Panchamahabhutas. Therefore, it is subtle in nature. We might have seen this somewhere earlier. See, from, that is, Maya, Prakriti, Maya. Brahma cannot create. It is Avikari. Prakriti, Maya Shakti, the creative power also cannot create. Why? It is inert in nature. But in the presence of Sarvyapi Chaitanya Swarupa Brahma, Maya creates the Jagat. It is the Maya, Prakriti, which is the Sarjana Shakti, the creative power which undergoes the modification. But this Maya Shakti is constituted of three gunas. Three gunas are Sattva Guna, Rajo Guna, Tamo Guna. See, for anything to create, first you should have the knowledge, the know-how of creating something. Suppose some manufacturer has manufactured this microphone. Can he do that without the technical know-how of how to manufacture? Jnana is required now. That jnana corresponds to sattva guna. Then action is involved. Simply knowing is not going to do that. He has to do labor force, machineries, and this and that, etc. That power action aspect corresponds to rajo guna. But that itself is not sufficient. Raw material is required or not, metals, etc. required or not. That raw material corresponds to tamo guna. So that we have got a creation or not. It should necessarily have all the three aspects. We can trace its origin in the Maya Shakti in terms of Sattva Guna, Rajo Guna, and Tamo Guna. So that being the case. Now, what happens? What have I got now? Sattva guna, rajo guna, tamo guna. They are in what form? When actually, tasmadva etasmad atmana akasha sambhuta akashad vayu vayo ragni ragni rapa adhya prithivi. All are in what? Up to sukshma form, tanmatra form, subtle form. Now, but subtle form though, they are from where? Prakriti maya vijitri guna atmika. So that means its effect, each of this element also is trigunatmika or not? It has got in its constituent sattva guna, rajo guna and tamo guna. What happens is, from now how many elements are there? Five, space, air, fire, water, earth. Then the sukshma form. Each one is trigunatmika, is it not? So therefore, what happens is, each of the sattva aspect of the five elements goes into the constitution of individual jnanendriya. Fine? Then aggregate of the sattvic aspect of that goes into the constitution of antakkarana. Fine, that is okay. Means what has happened? Jnanendriyas and antakkarana are created. Now rajasic aspect of in tanmatra of each of the five elements goes into the constitution of individual karmendriya. Individual karmendriya. The aggregate of the rajasic content of the five elements goes into the making of the prana. So that means what is accounted now? Jnanendriyas, antakarana, karmendriyas, prana. Made up of the sukshma elements. From there, what content? Rajas sattvic and rajasic content individually and also aggregated. Now remaining, this we already seen panchikarana process. Remaining tamasic content undergoes the process what is called as panchikarana and gives rise to five gross elements. These five gross elements go into the making of our all gross bodies and the gross world. That in the case, say. So this is what, now Sukshareera is made up of Sukshma, that is Sukshma aspect of the five element, therefore it is called as Sukshma Shareera. Further description and other names for this Sukshareera.
इदं शरीरं शृणु सूक्ष्म संहितम् लिंगं त्वपञ्चीकृत भूत संभवम् सवासनं कर्म फलानुभावकम् स्वाज्ञानतो नादिरूपादिरात्मनः इदं शरीरं शृणु सूक्ष्मसंज्ञितम् लिङ्गं त्वपञ्चीकृतभूतसम्भवम् सवासनं कर्म फलानुभावकम् स्वाज्ञानतो नादिरूपाधिरात्मनः अन्वय इदं अपञ्चीकृतभूतसम्भवम् सूक्ष्म संज्ञितं शरीरं शृणु तु लिंगं कर्मफलानुभावकं सवासनं स्वाज्ञानतः आत्मनः अनादिः उपाधिः अगेन इदं अपंचीकृत भूत संभवं सूक्ष्म संवृतं शरीरं शृणु तु लिंगं कर्मफलानुभावकं स्ववासनं स्वअज्ञानतः आत्मनः अनादिः उपाधिः।
इदं अपंचीकृत भूत संभव। दिस शरीर सटल बॉडी मेड अप ऑफ व्हाट? भूत संभव, बॉर्न ऑफ द भूत। विच भूत? अपंचीकृत, बिफोर अंडरगोइंग द ग्रॉसिफिकेशन, व्हाट इज कॉल्ड एज पंचीकरण प्रोसेस, अपंचीकृत भूत संभव। एंड इट इज कॉल्ड व्हाट? सूक्ष्म संज्ञितम, संज्ञितम कॉल्ड, कॉल्ड एज व्हाट? सूक्ष्म शरीर, इट इज कॉल्ड एज सूक्ष्म शरीर। सूक्ष्म संज्ञितम शरीरम शृणु मीन्स नो इट टू बी व्हाट? सूक्ष्म शरीर मेड अप ऑफ फाइव एलिमेंट्स बिफोर अंडरगोइंग ग्रॉसिफिकेशन। एंड टू लिंगम, two is that to show the contrast with the gross body. In contrast with the gross body, it is called, it is what? Lingam. What is lingam? Actually, linga is a sign, a mark, or an evidence. A sign or a mark, literally, or an evidence means it makes you know something. Let me give an example. You see the smoke. What does it convey? There is fire. Is it not? There is fire. Means what happened? The smoke is the linga for fire. You have not seen fire. Fire is not seen. Let us say mountain is under the mountain, and what is that? Boulders of smoke are coming. That means what? That is the linga. Now, sthula sharira is described. Suksha sharira is described. Come on, tell me, made up of what? Sthula sharira is made up of panchikrita panchamahabhutas, gross five elements. Agreed? Suksha sharira is made up of apanchikrita panchamahabhutas, that is subtle five elements. That means both gross body and subtle body, we know what it all consists of, made up of five elements, gross and the subtle. Tell me, these five elements, are they sachetana or jada, inert? Invariably they are inert. Gross, five elements are what? Inert by themselves. Are you inert? Are you inert? I am not asking figuratively. not manda, etc. But you smiled means you understood. Or at least you wondering. What question this Swami is asking? Unnecessarily asking hundreds of questions. Is it not? Or you try to understand. Can any inert thing try to understand? If that is the case, do you know what will happen? These walls, windows, fans, chairs will be more knowledgeable than you. Because you take many time French leave to the class also. But so long as I come and sit and talk, these poor fellows can't go anywhere. They have to listen. Is it that way? No, it is not that way at all. So that means what happened? This embodiment comprising gross and subtle bodies must necessarily be inert in nature because it is made up of the five what inert elements. And yet, what is the linga available? It is sachetana. It is lively. it is vibrant with the sentiency. What does it mean? There must be present, what must be present? A principle which itself is Chaitanya Tattva, awareness principle, consciousness principle. Yes or no? That is Linga. Linga means a mark, a sign, what is called as Jnapaka. Jnapaka means that one which makes you know, that one which reveals to you. So this body, though inert, is, this means, is sachetana, means there must be a chetanata tattva, chaitanya tattva in this body. And that is what is called, what is what? Chaitanya swarupa atma. Now, atma is there or not? Yes, why? Because I am what? Come on, fill in the blank. I am sentient, sachetana. I am sachetana. Is not linga. Who gives this clue? Not the cross body. A dead person's cross body, there nothing there. But suksha sharira. That is why when a person dies, suksha sharira goes, sab kuch thanda ho gaya. Because this is, that means the presence of the chetanata is not available. This we have seen. You may ask one question. This Chaitanya Sarupa Atma Brahma is said to be Sarvavyapi. If it is Sarvavyapi, is it not true that this body should always be Sachetana, sentient? Yes or no? But is it so? No. If that were the case, there will not be death. And if there will not be death, Ishvara will be in problem. He will not be able to manage the world as such. Because any srishti means srishti, creation, sthiti, sustenance, and samvara, destruction. A constructive destruction is the part of creation. If all of our great, 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 great grandparents were present, what would have happened? In the Andheri, one bedroom, flat, what will happen? Somebody said, see, last few days, marriage after marriage, after he said, abhi bolte, death after death. Bhagwan ko balance dekhne ka. because for the new arrivals, what should be there? There should be, the clearance must be there or not. Oh, Bhagwan ka baat hai, that is not our job as such. He knows the balance. It is governed by law of karma. That okay, there's nothing to do with that. It is governed by law of karma. So that means again, samvara, destruction. So therefore, what happens? Now if Atma is all-pervasive, it should be always sachetana. No. For example, now, this electrical wire circuit is there. Or let us say, for entire school. Do you mean to say, all the time, all the fans, all the lights, they function? That is what is called as what? A switch. You put on the switch, the present electricity is available for that gadget to function. Is it not? Same law here. In the gross body, there is a switch. What is that switch? Sukshma Sharira. It's a different type of switch. This switch is always there. You, at your will, you put on and put off. But Bhagavan is very clever. He has not given the aspect of putting off and on in our hand. If it were in our hand, then he will be in problem. Because when it is to be put off, you will not put off. and you may put off when it is not to be put. In life, so all problems, etc. People commit suicide, is it not? Huh? They commit suicide. When problems came, this fellow is suddenly put off the etc. And suppose that this fellow doesn't want to die, etc. Great granddaughter's marriage is tomorrow and the Yamaraja is knocking at the door, chup-chap, no, terror. So not that. So therefore Bhagavan has done what is there. He has not lock, stock, barrel. He just removes the switch from the, where? From the gross body. It is governed by his laws unless abused. When? In the case of suicide or homicides, there it is abused. In the case of natural death, it is what? It is governed by the laws of Ishvara. So that is that. That's why they say, some people think that suicide is a solution to their problem. Satya Sai Baba once said, if only they come to know what happens afterwards, they will never dare to think of suicide. You know, persons who commit suicide, they undergo such a torturous condition. You know why? Present body is ordered by the law of karma. It has got a duration. In its natural death, what would happen? This body got destroyed. Next body is ready as per the law of karma. Now this person has misused the will and ended the present body. The next body is not ready. Hunger, thirst, all this torment because they cannot be satiated without a gross body. And there is a, whatever it may be, irrespective of type of it, gross body must be there. It is a very, very torturous condition because it is just like vacating the tenement without making arrangement for the other place. So like that, so it is the, anyway, so that being the case, so this is, it is, that is why this Sukshara is thrown out by who? Udana, at the time of death, at the time of natural death person. So that it is called as what? Lingam. It is called as the Linga Sharira. What all it has got? It is Karma Phalanubhavakam. It gives us the anubhava, the experience of our karma phalas. See, karma phalas are in terms of papa and punya. Punya gives joy, papa gives sorrow. This experience of papa punya is presented by what? This sukshma chara. How do you say so? Because for gaining, reaping the karma phala in terms of sukha dukkha, we have to interact with the world, is it not? We have to interact with the world comprising vishaya, sense object, shabda, sparsha, rupa, rasa, gandha. How are you going to interact with them? Don't you need jnanendriyas? Don't you need karmendriyas? Are they sufficient? No. Antakarana, mana, buddhi, ahankara, chitta. Again, body should function, physiological function, prana. Who does all this? Sukshma, sharir. Otherwise, then what will happen? A dead body also should be able to experience. No, not possible. So therefore, sukshma sharira enables us to interact with the world itself functioning and makes us, it is available for reaping the experiences of sukha dukkha according to our papa punya, the karma phala. Karma phalanubhavakam, which makes us undergo the experiences in accordance with our karma phala, papa and punya. Savasanam, it is with vasana. Vasana is अनुभवजन्य संस्काराः. वासना इज व्हाट? अनुभवजन्य संस्कार. द इम्प्रेशंस इन द साइकी अंतःकरण बॉर्न ऑफ पास्ट एक्सपीरियंसेस. सो इट इज देयर इन द दिस सूक्ष्म शरीर. सूक्ष्म शरीर इज द स्टोर हाउस ऑफ दिस. अदरवाइज से ए बेबी डक टेक्स टू वाटर. विच ट्रेनिंग स्कूल इट वेंट? बेबी मंकी. हैव यू सीन बेबी मंकी? इट क्लैश द मदर. हु टॉट? मदर टॉट. बेबी यू शुड होल्ड मी. वी आर ऑन द टॉप ऑफ ए ट्री ऑफ सुबह 150 हाई. इफ यू फॉल डाउन सब चक्का चूर हो जाएगा. इज इट दैट वे? ए चाइल्ड सकिंग द मदर्स मिल्क. हु टॉट? Already programmed. Who programmed? Samskar. Bhagavan has already kept the software there. Mostly hardware is now produced. That's all. Hardware is produced. See, Bhagavan. Before these fellows could invent software, etc., Bhagavan has done that. That is savasanam along with the samskaras of the past. Anubhava, savasanam. And do you know what happens? It becomes an upadhi for atma on account of ajnana, on account of ignorance. Svajnanataha. Svajnanataha on account of, so what is that? Ignorance of one's own swarupa, it becomes what? Atmanaha anadi upadhi. It becomes a upadhi, a beginningless upadhi for atma. So we have to encounter one word now. Upadhi is a technical term. We should know it very clearly because this upadhi word is going to come left and right. Means Vedanta means upadhi is there. What is upadhi? In the common parlance, you know upadhi. You know, Mr. So and So. Afterwards, what is there? Degrees, etc. are there, no? So they are called upadhis. They are also called as the upadhi. A person got married, upadhi. Got children. Addition to upadhi, addition to upadhi. This is all general. But here, in Vedanta, upadhi means upa. Upa means samipavartini, vastuni, sviya dharman, adadhati. Upa. Upa means nearby. Samipavartini, vastuni. In a given thing, sviya dharman, one's own features, one's own characteristic feature. Adadhati means as though imparts. Adadhati means deposit. Literally it means deposits. Deposits means imparts. If we take an example, it will be clear. Say, look, see on this desk, this orange cloth is there. Suppose a crystal is kept on this orange cloth. You know? What is the color of the crystal? Colorless. But when it is kept on the orange cloth, do you know what happens? The crystal appears as if it is orange. A child who doesn't know, he says what? Orange crystal is there, it will tell. But actually, the crystal is colorless. From where did it get the orange color? From the orange cloth. But crystal has not become orange. Don't think that. See, the orange cloth has not made the crystal orange, but it made it appear as orange. Now let us see the definition. What happens is, this cloth becomes upadhi for Krishna. Why? Upa, nearby, samipavartani, vastuni, what is the vastu here? Crystal, sviya dharma, what is that orange color? Adadati, as though imparts. Really it doesn't impart, as though impart. So therefore, this colored cloth becomes the upadhi for whom? Krishna. This is understood. For Atma. Now suppose, a person knows the crystal as colorless. Even if it appears as orange, he knows what it is. It is colorless. Right? He has seen the colorless crystal. So that means that color, appearance color, in spite of that, he knows that it is color. Like that. Do you know what happened? Atma, Chaitanya Rupa, Atma, is in its true nature totally free from embodiment and consequent samsara. Samsara means what? Sukha dukkha. Experiences. Sukha dukkha atmaka experience. But what is our present plight? Sukha dukkha atmaka experiences are there or not? Samsara is there or not? Who made it? Sukshma sharira. Sukshma sharira. Sukshma sharira. Sukshma sharira made it, because all this belongs to sukshma and sthula sharira, not to atma. But an adhyanataha, not knowing the swarupa, what is mistaken is the features of upadhi, the sukshma and sthula sharira, appear as though belonging to atma. Just as the color of the cloth appears as though belonging to the crystal. Why? Adhyana. What adhyana? Doesn't know that crystal is colorless. So also here, not knowing the atma to be free from samsara due to ignorance, this is the sukshara, which is karma phalanu bhavakaha, makes it appear as though I am a samsari. All that Vedanta does is to make you directly discover that you are totally free from samsara, you are Paramananda Swarupa, provided what? Provided what? You are available. You are available not so simply Sunday evening classes, okay? Not simply that. You are available to pursue the path. What is the path? See, the author has taken so much of pain in the introduction. What is necessary? What is indispensable? Sadhana chatushtaya. Sadhana chatushtaya sampatti, viveka vairagya shamadamadi shatka sampatti mumukshu. In which, what is the most prominent thing? If one or two are there, others will come. Vairagya means viveka. Vairagya and mumukshutva. This should be intense, because in the absence of these, the mind is not available for the pursuit, because it gets preoccupied in many other things. That is why Shankaracharya has to spend so much, in detail, so many illustrations he has given. So that is why I said, provided you are available. A doctor can cure the disease provided the patient is available. That is that. So that being the case, so that is upadhi atmanaha, anadi upadhi atmanaha. So therefore it is a upadhi. Now you see, no upadhi, which as though imparts its feature in a nearby thing. Really, it doesn't. That's why Sukshma Sharira is the one which plays this mischief of making us assume that this Sukha Dukhatmaka Samsara belongs to who? Our Swarupa, which is not the true thing at all. What was the exclusive state of gross body? Waking state. What is the exclusive state of subtle body? Dream state. That is now going to be explained.
Om Swastik Prajapya Parihalayam.